real estate industry, which created all the economic activity.
First, let me take an opportunity to thank Congresswoman Sanchez and CHCI for the opportunity to speak on what I think is a critical issue for the Latino community and broadcasters alike. Good morning. My first question is, how many folks in this room watch local television? By a show of hands. Okay. I think it's important that you also know that local television depends upon the spectrum that we're talking about here today, whether it's for direct over-the-air transmission of our signal directly to viewers, or whether it's to the cable head ends and satellite service providers that you might receive your programming from. So I want to take a couple of minutes to discuss four things. You know, what are broadcasters doing with the spectrum they have now? Because I think there's there's some misinformation out there that we are an old technology, that we're not moving forward. The second, I want to talk a little bit about why it's important to protect local broadcasting. And third, I'm going to talk about congressional activity that may imperil local broadcasting. And finally, I'll tell you what our simple asks are. So to what we're doing with our spectrum, you know, we had a digital television transition about 2 years ago that was completed, before which we could only deliver over an analog television stream one primary video programming stream. After the DTV transition, it opened up an opportunity to provide multiple channels of programming, mobile DTV, and enhanced high-definition television programming for free to the viewing public. I'm happy to report that today broadcasters offer more than 1,400 multicast channels nationwide, important specifically to this community because many of those channels are foreign language programming. For instance, in New York, of the 32 multicast channels that we have out there, 13 are foreign language programming. In LA, of the 52 multicast channels that are operating, 18 are foreign language programming, including Hispanic programming, Asian American programming, Korean programming, and Vietnamese programming. So, and right here in Washington, 9 of our 23 multicast channels are foreign language programming. So we've added to the diversity of voices with the programming we're providing with our high-definition television. We've also got mobile DTV that's rolling out in 70 stations across the country. This will enable viewers to get for free high-definition program on the back seats of their cars, on mobile devices, so they can have their programming where and when they want it. And then, of course, we're providing enhanced high-definition programming for all of our viewers. So that's what we've done with our spectrum. Why is it important to continue to protect this spectrum, this asset? It's because, in addition to all the new groovy things that we're doing with our television spectrum, we still serve a vital role in the community as first informers in a time of emergency. When there is an emergency, do you grab your cell phone or do you turn on your local television station to find out what the problem is? I'd ask that question first. So as we contemplate policies in Washington that may do violence to our ability to reach folks, our viewers, we should always consider first that our most important job as broadcasters is to keep our folks informed during times of emergency. Secondly, in addition to sort of the public safety aspect that we've, the role that we've always filled, we impact the economy in a huge way. So we recently commissioned a study that determined that local TV's impact on the U.S. economy is more than $716 billion and supports 1.5 million American jobs today. So as we think about policies in Washington that could affect the television industry, we should keep that in mind as well. I'm going to try and sum this up quickly. What are the policies in Washington that could be a problem for broadcasters? The voluntary broadband plan that was announced by the FCC about a year and a half ago now calls for voluntary return of TV station licenses for those TV broadcasters who no longer wish to be TV broadcasters. Sounds innocuous enough. There's, you know, it's all voluntary. What's the problem? The problem is that the broadband plan calls for taking 20 additional channels from the 2 through 51 that we currently operate in and moving them down into channels 2 through 31. And we're concerned that as Congress writes the laws that give the FCC the authority to do this, that when the deck is reshuffled, that folks who want to stay and continue to provide service to our over-the-air viewers, the Latino community who relies on over-the-air television by a factor of about 1 to 3, that these folks to my left and right will continue to be able to serve that community. That is to say, if you push what is presently residing in channels 2 through 51 to channels 2 through 31, you can't do it without shrinking the coverage area of the stations who want to remain. And that is our principal concern. We want to make sure that our contours and your reception is protected as we move forward. I'll end there. There are a number of statements that Michelle and Chris have made that I'd like to explore and unpack a little bit. But I think at the end of the day, it's important to remember that broadcasters aren't opposed to truly voluntary auctions. But truly voluntary auctions means that the folks who want to stay are protected as well.